the fascinating world of trivia, where even a right answer can catch you in a trap. On Trivia Trap! The juniors are ready, the seniors are set to play, and here's the host of Trivia Trap, Bob Eubanks!
Thank you very much. Hello, everybody. Welcome again to Trivia Trap. Glad you could join us this morning because we have two teams ready to play our game, and let's meet them right now. First of all, the seniors who have all reached their 30th birthday, returning champions back again today. Let's say hi to them. Hello, Rosemary.
Hi, Bob. I'm Rosemary Franz, and I'm a portrait artist.
Didn't win the $10,000 yesterday, yeah. But boy, you're going to try it again today, aren't you? Don?
Hi, Bob. I'm Don Gustafson. I'm retired. I was formerly a sales manager in the computer industry.
Welcome back, Don and Beth.
Hi, I'm Beth Boyd, and I'm a dancer.
Good. Ladies and gentlemen, our returning champions are the seniors. And here to test your trivia knowledge, a new set of juniors, and it looks like they're ready, so let's meet them right now. Sheri?
Hi, I'm Sheri Zolman. I'm a senior at UCLA majoring in biology.
Wonderful. Debbie?
Hi, Bob. My name's Debbie Mingoya, and I'm a customer service representative.
All right. And Mark?
Hi, Bob. I also, too, am a dancer and a waiter, and I'm a criminal justice senior at San Diego State University.
Is that your little thing right there?
That's my buddy.
Garth. That's your buddy, Junior. If you're ready to play our game, let's begin as we always do with our seniors. Rosemary, you get to make the choice first, same as yesterday. Okay. What I'm going to ask you to do is pick a row of answers for your team to play for, and let's take a look at those answers right now. Up on the top row, we find these. Miniature Emmy, condo in Hawaii, new Porsche, or oil painting of himself. On the bottom are these. Doctors, farmers, merchants, lawyers. Will it be the top or the bottom row?
They say the bottom.
Want to go for the bottom row? All right, seniors, here's your question. Nearly half of the signers of the Declaration of Independence belong to what profession? Now, here's what you must do. You must cut answers, three answers, until you get to the right answer. So I'm going to ask you to cut the three wrong answers. If you do, you get $300. So let me repeat the question. Nearly half of the signers of the Declaration of Independence belong to what profession? Cut an incorrect answer, Rosemary.
I'll cut doctors.
I want to cut the answer, doctors. All right, let's do that for our seniors. Eliminate doctors. It's a good choice.
Good.
Don, we're trying to find the wrong answers in order to get to the right answer.
Bob, let's cut merchants.
You're right.
They're turning against you.
The audience says, oh, but let's cut merchants for the seniors. Yeah. You bet. Well, Beth? Two answers remain. One is the right answer, one is the wrong answer. If you can find the last wrong answer, your team gets $300. Half of the signers of the Declaration of Independence belong to what profession? The final wrong answer is what?
I'm going to make a really good guess and say lawyers.
You want to cut the answer?
Lawyers, yes.
Great. Oh, it sounds logical. Back in those days, farmers and everything.
Farmers.
You think farmers is the mm-hmm. correct answer. Let's see if you are right. Cut the answer, lawyers, from that list. No, you hit the old trivia trap. Those lawyers have been in politics since I don't know when. Believe me.
Yeah.
No, they were lawyers. All right, you did eliminate two of the wrong answers. That means you get $100. And seniors, you're on your way. And for the very first time, let's go over and give our juniors a chance to play the game. Sheri, you know what you have to do. Pick a row of answers for your team. Miniature Emmy, condo in Hawaii, new Porsche, or oil painting of himself. That's on the top. On the bottom are these, juniors. Ronald Reagan, Groucho Marx, Mark Goodson, John Wayne. What would it be?
I'll take the bottom.
You want the bottom row? I'm taking the top row. I don't know. Here's your question, juniors. From 1952 to 1961, Ralph Edwards hosted every show of This Is Your Life, except two. One man was his substitute host. Who was that man? You have to find the wrong answers. Sheri?
Okay, I'm going to start by cutting Mark Goodson.
Yes. You do that, but I'm not going to do that. Let's cut the answer, Mark Goodson.
All right.
Yes. Debbie, find another wrong answer.
I'm going to cut John Wayne.
Yes. Okay. Let's eliminate John Wayne from that group of answers. Indeed. Mark, what is that in front of you?
I hope he's my good luck charm.
What is he?
Garfield. I'm a Garfield fanatic.
I think that's great.
I know you're pulling my tail. Bob, I'm going to cut Ronald Reagan.
Let's see what Garfield has to say about this one. Eliminate Ronald Reagan. Oh. Garfield didn't help you that time. No. Ralph Edwards was ill January 30th and February 6th in 1957. The one man who hosted those two shows was Ronald Reagan. You hit the trivia trap. However, you did eliminate two of those answers, so you tied the game up with $100. Right. We will be back with more Trivia Tap right after these very important words. Juniors have $100. Seniors have $100. Remember, it's the team that gets to $1,000 that wins the game and goes on for a chance to play at $10,000. And let's go back to our seniors. And Don, take a look, if you would, please. Miniature Emmy condo in Hawaii, new Porsche, or oil painting of himself. That's the top row. Donald, on the bottom, you'll find these. The apartment, some like it hot, Days of Wine and Roses, and Save the Tiger.
Bottom
row it is. And the question, seniors. Jack Lemmon received Oscar nominations for all of these movies. For which film did Lemmon actually receive the Best Actor Oscar? Find the wrong answers, Don.
I'm going to cut Some Like It Hot.
Well, cut the answer, Some Like It Hot. Good luck to you. I hope you're correct in doing so. Let's cut Some Like It Hot. Very good indeed. Beth, another wrong answer.
I'm going to cut The Apartment.
The Apartment, you say?
Mm-hmm.
Good movie. Okay, cut the answer, The Apartment, for our seniors.
Yeah!
Safe again. Rosemary, we're looking for the film that Lemmon actually received the Best Actor Oscar. You must find the last wrong answer in order to pick up $300 for your team.
I'm going to cut Days of Wine and Roses.
Yes, 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 yes.
It's for $300. Let's eliminate the answer, The Days of Wine and Roses.
Yeah!
It was kind of a tricky question.
Yeah.
It really was, because he previously had won Best Supporting Actor as Ensign Pulver in the 1955 movie Mr. Roberts, but he won the Oscar for Best Actor in a movie called Save the Tiger, 1973. Good for you guys. $300 added to your one. You now have $400. And we're going to give our juniors a chance to do some catching up. Debbie, you pick the row of answers for your team. Up on top, Miniature Emmy begins that group. And on the bottom are these. Ulysses S. Grant, Andrew Johnson, Abraham Lincoln, or William McKinley? Top or the bottom?
We'll try the top. We'll be brave.
Going up there on the top. All right, chance to tie up this game if you can find the three wrong answers in order to get to the right answer. And here's the question. Tom Selleck has just presented his Magnum P.I. co-stars with something to show his appreciation for their contributions to the series. What did he give each of them? Cut the wrong answers. Deb, you may begin.
I'm going to cut Miniature Emmy.
To cut the answer, Miniature Emmy. Oh, you don't think you'd do that, huh?
Oh.
I don't think you'd do that either. Cut the answer, Miniature Emmy.
Come on.
Yeah! So right. All right, Garfield.
I don't think he's vain enough, so I'm gonna cut oil painting of himself.
I'm gonna cut the answer, oil painting of himself. I don't know, man. Let's see. Cut that answer, oil painting of himself.
Yeah!
You're right. Well, Sheri, chance to tie this game up. There's one more incorrect answer up there. It's either new Porsche or a condo in Hawaii. The question, naturally, is what did Tom Selleck present his co-stars, a Magnum P.I., to show appreciation for their contribution to the series? Find the last wrong answer, Sheri.
Okay, this is clueless guest time. I'm going to cut new Porsche.
Gonna cut the answer, new Porsche. Listen to the audience. They think he would give everybody a new Porsche. You think he's going to give them a condo in Hawaii?
Yes.
So.
Let's cut new Porsche.
Oh.
That's what he did. Hey, that's pretty nice, though. Larry Minetti, Roger E. Mosley, John Hillerman each received a brand new Porsche from Tom Selleck to show his appreciation. Really a nice gesture. Yes. Two incorrect answers you cut. Add another $100 to your total. You now have $200. Seniors have $400. And we're going to pause for these words and be right back. Remember, it's the team that gets to $1,000 that wins the game. Before we do, go to commercial. We never did get to all of those presidents, Grant, Johnson, Lincoln, and McKinley. How about we play the game with you at home? Here was the question. Gerald Ford was president when we celebrated America's 200th birthday. Hey, who was president when America celebrated its 100th birthday? You know? I'll tell you the answer. We'll come back to play our trivia race right after this. Give me a tap. Well, as we said, Gerald Ford was president of the United States when we celebrated our 200th birthday. Who was president when we celebrated our 100th birthday? It was Ulysses S. Grant. That was the correct answer. Back to our competition between our juniors and our seniors. Juniors have $200. Returning champions, the seniors, have $400. The goal is to get to $1,000. And the way we do that is to play our trivia race. So if you come with me, we're going to go over and do that right now. Here we go. Now, remember, we'll play the trivia race until one of our teams reaches $1,000. The team that gets there first then has a chance to play for $10,000. And, as I said, our returning champions are out in front. The seniors have $400. In the trivia race, every question is worth $100. After the 10th question, however, then the values double. They'll go to $200. Each team will have three chances to come up with a correct answer. If all three of you miss, control will then go over to the other team. Everybody understand the rules? If you do, seniors, you're out in front. That means you got to go first. Rosemary, pick a question. TV news, love, shooting, or sun?
I'll take sun.
Sun. For $100, trying to get to 1,000, what's the full name of Cher's son with Greg Allman?
Don?
Blue Moon.
Sorry, Beth.
Elijah Blue Allman.
That's it. Whoa. Elijah Blue Allman. Blue Moon, huh, Don? Rosemary, pick a question. TV news, love shooting, or commonly known?
Let's take commonly known.
Commonly known for $100, seniors. What is nitrous oxide commonly known as?
Me?
Yes.
Laughing gas.
That's right, laughing gas. Now you have $600. Don, the question.
TV news, please.
TV news. For $100, who was the first woman to anchor a network news program?
Barbara Walters.
That's right, it is. Barbara Walters. 700. Trying to get to 1,000. Beth, what will it be?
Oh, let's try Bourne.
Bourne. For $100, in what British hospital did Diana, Princess of Wales, just give birth to Prince Henry?
Ooh, good question.
Thank you. Rosemary?
Laying in hospital.
Sorry, Don.
Little Company of Mary.
You're not too far away. It was St. Mary's. You're frozen at $700. Let's go to our juniors. Sheri, pick a question, please.
Let's take comeback.
Comeback. And that's what you need, juniors. You have 200 trying to get to 1,000. James Cagney had retired for 20 years until he made a return to the screen in a 1981 film. What film was it? Debbie?
Ragtime.
It was Ragtime. Good. $300. Mark, pick a question.
Let's try first.
First, for $100, contestants, who was the first person born in the U.S. to be canonized as a saint?
St. Mary of Assisi.
Sorry, Sheri?
John.
No, I'm sorry, Debbie.
St. Peter?
No, incorrect. Mother Elizabeth Seton, founder of the American Sisters of Charity. You're frozen at $300. Back to the seniors. Beth, pick a question.
Go.
Beth?
My turn. Love shooting.
Love shooting. For $100, here's the question. In the folk ballad, Frankie shot Johnny with her six-shooter because she caught him with another woman. Who was the other woman? Not Rosemary?
Francie.
No. Don?
Alice.
A lot of people took the blame. It was Nellie Bly.
Oh, Nellie.
Caught him with Nellie Bly. You're frozen at $700. Back to the juniors we go. All right, Mark.
Let's try Outlaws.
Outlaws. For $100, juniors, if Bonnie had married Clyde, what would her last name have been? Sheri?
Jillian.
Sorry, Debbie?
Bowden.
No, close. Barrel. Clyde Barrel. Should have been Bonnie Barrel. You're frozen at $300. Back to the seniors. $700 trying to get to 1,000. Beth?
Let's try Ad Campaign.
Ad Campaign. For $100, seniors, does she or doesn't she plug what ladies' product?
Color, hair coloring.
Rosemary?
Underwear.
Don?
Hair coloring.
That's not the correct answer, though. The product. Product was Clairol. $700 back to the juniors with $300 trying to get to 1,000. Mark, pick a question.
TV cartoon.
TV cartoons. Come on, juniors. In the cartoon TV series The Bullwinkle Show, what was the name of the town where Rocky and Bullwinkle lived?
Rockville.
Oh, Sheri.
Bullville.
Debbie, can you save your team?
No, I can't.
They live at Frostbite Falls. There's a man sitting there with a cat in front of him, and he doesn't know about Bullwinkle. I'm worried about it. You're frozen at $300. That was our 10th question. Hereafter. Okay, hereafter, every question is worth $200. Garfield just took a ride. Beth.
Let's try adolescence.
Adolescence for $200. Here's your question. In what book loved by young people do you find the character of Holden Caulfield?
Oh, Catcher in the Rye.
That's Catcher in the Rye, yes. $900. Rosemary?
Let's try Myth.
Myth. This is it. If you answer this question correctly, you win the game and a chance to play for $10,000. Here it is. In Greek mythology, Pandora opened a box and released all of man's troubles. Who gave Pandora the box?
Prometheus?
No. Don. Beth, save your team.
Oh, jeez.
Oh, geez, didn't do it. It was Zeus. You're frozen at 900 to the juniors. Mark.
Terms.
Terms. For $200, excuse me, in which athletic event would you find a Fosbury flop?
Diving.
Sheri.
Swimming.
Oh. Incorrect. Debbie.
High jump.
High jump is right, yes. Save your team. You have $500. Okay, Mark, again, pick the question, Mark.
Let's go with Elvis.
Elvis for $200. Juniors, in the 1970 film Change of Habit, a nun falls in love with Elvis Presley. Who plays the nun?
Shirley MacLaine.
Sorry, Sheri.
Sandra Dee.
Sorry, Debbie.
Shirley MacLaine.
No. Neither the time was it Shirley MacLaine. It was Mary Tyler Moore.
Mary Tyler.
Frozen at $500. Back to the seniors. Rosemary, you need one more. What will it be?
Let's try First Woman.
First Woman. Here it is. For the game and a chance to play for $10,000, who was the first woman in the history of the United States to be appointed to the president's cabinet? Don?
Perkins.
That's right, Francis Perkins! You're right! And the seniors remain champions. Woo! Where did he ever come up with Francis Perkins? I have no idea. $500, you can split it four ways. Garfield had a great deal to do with all of this. Sheri, thank you very much. Debbie, nice to see you. Mark, good luck. Garfield, see ya. Okay. Our seniors, our champions will be right back to give a chance to play for $10,000 right after this. Seniors, come in here. You're our champion still. Back for a return visit. You didn't get the $10,000 yesterday. Now we're going to play for $10,000. I want you to win it today. So go right over there and get in position, and good luck to you. Now, up until now, our seniors have played as partners, but now, as you know, you're on your own. Beth, you're in the number one spot. That means you get the opportunity to pass or play. And the first set of answers, let's go right up our ladder toward $10,000. The first row of answers look like this. Great Britain, the Confederacy, original 13 colonies, and Australia. Beth, play or pass?
I'll pass it.
You're going to pass it on to Don. Don, you can do the same thing. You can play or you can pass them to Rosemary.
I'll play, Bob.
Going to play. All right.
Why not?
It's worth $1,000 to you if you get it right. You get $1,000 and a chance to play for $10,000. Here's the question. The stars and bars are the nickname of whose flag? Is the correct answer Great Britain, the Confederacy, original 13 colonies, or Australia? Stars and bars.
The original 13 colonies.
Let's see if you're right. It's for $1,000. A chance to play for 10 big ones. Is it the original 13 colonies?
No.
The Confederacy. I'm sorry you've been eliminated for today. You'll be back tomorrow with your team. See you tomorrow, Don. Okay, let's go again to the next rung of our ladder, where we'll find another group of answers for Beth and Rosemary. Here they are, organ, harpsichord, accordion, piano. Again, Beth, play or pass?
I'll play it.
Going to play for these.
Yeah.
For $1,000, Beth, what is the oldest keyboard instrument? The oldest keyboard instrument? Organ, harpsichord, accordion, or piano? Which will it be?
I'll say harpsichord.
Harpsichord. For $1,000, a chance to play for $10,000. Is it harpsichord? The organ was the correct answer. Again, we must say goodbye to you for today.
Bye.
We'll see you tomorrow when you'll be back with your team. I think we've done this before, haven't we, Rosemary? Yesterday, same situation. Let's see if you can't change your luck and win $10,000 today. Okay, here we go. Up to the next level of our ladder. And they are Tokyo, L.A., Mexico City, Detroit. The question. The most McDonald's hamburgers eaten in one day at one restaurant was 17,000. Where did this occur? I need the correct answer.
I'll say Los Angeles.
Los Angeles is your answer. It's for $1,000 and a chance to play for $10,000. How about it? Was it a McDonald's in Los Angeles? No. It was in Tokyo. Oh, I'm sorry. No $10,000 today either. All right, we must pause. We'll be right back in just a moment with more Trivia Trap. See you in just a minute. Welcome back to Trivia Trap. Well, you do so good. So good throughout the game. You get right to that $10,000. Haven't hit it yet. I want you to come back tomorrow. We're going to try it all over again, okay? And tomorrow, I'd love to see you win that $10,000. We must go. For today, I'm Bob Eubanks. For everybody at Trivia Trap, saying so long, everybody. See you tomorrow. Bye-bye.
I'm going to say a moth.
You're going to say a moth. I got to ask you this, Joe.
Mm-hmm.
Is that your final answer?
Yeah, a moth.
He just won a million!